Hello friends, in this video we are going to learn the concept of backlash nonlinearity. Now backlash nonlinearity and hysteresis both are a bit similar, with a change that backlash is a concept which is applicable in mechanical gear systems and hysteresis is a concept which is applicable in magnetic circuits. So let us first define what is the meaning of backlash. Backlash is defined as a play between the teeth of a driver gear and those of a driven gear. So backlash is a play between the driver teeth and the driven gear teeth. So what is the meaning of play actually? Play means it's a small distance or a small gap between the driver gear and the driven gear. Now this nonlinearity is commonly occurring in physical mechanical systems such as gear trains, linkage, etc. And is like hysteresis. Please make a note, it is like hysteresis, but it is different from magnetic circuits. It is like hysteresis, but from different magnetic circuits. So once again, a quick review. What is backlash? Backlash is defined as a play between the teeth of a driver gear and those of a driven gear. And this nonlinearity is commonly occurring in the physical mechanical systems such as gear train and linkage, and is like hysteresis, but it is different from mechanical hysteresis. Now this three figures shows the important diagrams in backlash. Figure A shows the mechanical system. Figure B shows the play between the driver gear and the driven gear. And figure 3 shows the output graph. So, now, as shown in the figure C, it gives a relation between the input and the output motion. On x-axis, I am having input motion, and on y-axis, I am having output motion. Figure B shows the tooth A of a driver gear. So this is my driver gear. And this is located in midway between the teeth B1 and B2 of a driven gear. So this is my driven gear. So this teeth is located in somewhat middle of what? The driven gear. So this much distance is given as what? B/2. And similarly, this much distance is also given as what? B/2. Now, as the tooth A is driven clockwise. As the tooth A is driven clockwise from the position, no output motion takes place until the tooth A makes a complete contact with the tooth B1 of the driven gear after traveling the distance B/2. Now what am I going to do? I am going to move this driver gear A in the clockwise. So even though I am giving an input, this inner part of the gear will move in the clockwise direction, but there won't be any movement in B gear or in the driven gear unless and until this A gear moves the distance of B/2 and resides or touches the inner part with the inner part of B1. This output motion can be seen in the segment PQ of figure C. So figure C, PQ movement or PQ section is given by this particular diagram. So I have mentioned over here that this is my origin and this is my B/2 distance. So unless and until the B/2 distance is being traveled, there won't be any output. After the contact is made, the driven gear rotates counterclockwise through the same angle as the driver gear. Now, if the gear ratio is assumed to be what? Unity. Which means that after the contact is made, this contact, after the contact is been made by the driven gear rotates in the counterclockwise through the same angle as the driver gear. Now here, what is the assumption made? That the gear ratio is assumed to be what? Unity. This is shown in the segment QR of figure C. So this is my QR segment of figure C. As the input motion is reverse, the contact between teeth A and B1 is lost. As the input motion is reverse, the contact between A and B1 is lost, and the driven gear immediately becomes stationary. Now, the assumption, or it is based on the assumption, that load friction controlled with a negligible inertia. The output motion therefore ceases, or it remains nothing, or there is no output motion till tooth A has traveled the distance B. So this much distance, which you can see over here, is what? B distance. So what is the concept? The output motion therefore ceases till the tooth A has traveled the distance B in the reverse direction as given by the notation R and S. R and what? S. After the tooth establishes a contact with the tooth B2, after it makes a contact with tooth B2, the driven gear now moves in the clockwise direction, same as segment ST. So this segment ST in the clockwise direction. Now again, as the input motion is reverse, the driven gear again at a standstill position takes place, and this is shown by the segment TU. Which segment? TU. And then it follows the same path, that is path number U to path number what? R. Or from path U to path R, or we can say path U to path Q. Now this completes the one cycle. This has complete the one cycle. Now as we can see easily in figure number C, that for a given input, the output is what? Multi-valued. Now what is a multi-valued? We can say this is output number 1, this is output number 2, this part is output number 3, and let us say this part is output number 4. So what can I say? For a given input, the output is what? Multi-valued. Which particular output will result for a given input depends on the history of the input, and hence this type of nonlinearity has the inherent memory and is also referred as what? Memory type nonlinearity. This nonlinearity thus has inherent memory and is referred to as what? Memory type of nonlinearity. The width of the input-output curve is equal to backlash B, while the height corresponds to the limit of input angle. Now, this corresponds to backlash B, or we can say this width, this is a width, am I right? Yes, this is a width. So, the width of the input-output curve indicates the backlash, while the height corresponds the limit of the input angle. So this completes the concept of backlash nonlinearity. Thank you for watching this video.